Okay, so in class so far we have covered some really fundamental topics that we'll be building on from here on in. And so we've done a lot with distributions and descriptive statistics, and now we're switching to inferential statistics, which we'll talk about for the rest of the class, right? So as a reminder, inferential statistics allow researchers to make inferences or decisions about populations based on sample data. All right, and generally, you can think of there being four steps in a very broad sense for inferential statistics. So first off, you care about the state of the world. Notice this is about the population, and you're not curious about a sample, you're curious about the world out there. So I'm going to try to use a simple example, hopefully it's a simple example, and you're trying to figure out if a coin is a fair coin or not. Maybe somebody wants to make a bet, so for example you might wonder if a coin is fair or not. So what you do is you make observations that reflect the state of the world. So for example, you flip the coin. So this would be collecting your sample data. The third thing that you do is you calculate how likely the coin is fair given these observations. So for example, if you flip the coin 100 times, and every time you flipped it, the coin came up heads, you would probably suspect that it's not a fair coin, because it should come up heads only about half the time if it's fair. So you calculate this probability about the state of the world, and then you make a decision about the state of the world. So if you flip the coin 100 times, it came up heads all 100 times, you would decide that the coin is unfair. So this is the overall logic behind all of the inferential statistics that we're going to be talking about for the rest of the semester.